Hello, coders. We all talk about how great code reuse is, but how many of us actually reuse any of our source code, other than opening up an old project and copy-pasting code from the old project into our new projects? In this video, I'll show you how you can create NuGet packages that you can use just for your internal personal projects. You can share them with your coworkers for your business projects. And if you want, you can publish them to NuGet.org and share them with developers around the world. The first step is to decide what code you want to create for your package. The two main things I look at are, one, is it something that I repeatedly do across projects? In my case, I have an extension methods class that I typically add to each project. So that may be a good NuGet package to create. Or two, you may have something you've developed to help you simplify some of your other development. Like in this case, I created a Fluent Email class, which makes it easier to create mail message objects. Once you've decided what you want the package to contain, you create a new solution, and I created this class library project, Fluent Email. If we look at the project properties, we see the output class here is a class library, and the target framework is .NET Standard 2.0. Now it's important that you select the correct target framework. Within .NET, your .NET framework projects like 4.72, 4.8, they can't be used in a .NET Core or .NET 5, 6, or 7 project. What you want to do in general is create a .NET Standard project. This can be used by .NET Framework, .NET Core, .NET 5, 6, 7, it's the lowest common denominator for projects. However, there may be times when your project uses specific features of a specific version of .NET and you just have to go with where the features are available. Just try to get the target framework down to as low a version as possible so that way it can be used in more projects. Now that you have the class library project, you add your classes. In my case, I have this Fluent Email class and this Extension Methods class. And you would add any dependent packages that your project may need. Let's say I was doing some sort of JSON work in my classes. I could add something like Newtonsoft.json as a package for this project. And that's okay because when I create the NuGet package for my project, it will list Newtonsoft.json as a dependent package. So anyone who adds my NuGet package to their project, it will also add Newtonsoft.json to their project or any other dependent packages. Next in the project, if you're going to publicly publish this, it would be nice to add a license file and a README file. These are the files that were created when I added this to GitHub. You may also want to add an icon. I added this envelope.png. It's a CC0, Creative Commons 0 icon, so I don't need to have a license for it. And that's all the basic code I need for a NuGet package. If your package is more complex, you may have more classes, you may add more dependent packages to it, but this is the same basic idea for every NuGet package project that you'll create. Now, I highly suggest you treat this like a professional project. The idea is you're going to share code, so you want this to be high quality code. And for this project, since I'm publishing this publicly on NuGet.org, I wanted to make sure that the code was tested. So I created this test.fluentemail project with unit test, and this has 100% code coverage. If I right click on the solution and run my unit test with code coverage using ReSharper, we see that all of my tests pass, and we see that I have 100% code coverage. So this makes me feel confident that the code is high quality, and anyone who uses it is probably not going to run into a problem. Also, as part of treating this like a professional project, I have this in GitHub, and I have a public project for the source code so anyone can look at it. I have a fairly good README file here that tells what the package is about. I have a link to an instructions page so people can see here's how to use the package. I have a link to the issues page on GitHub so people can report bugs or request features, and I have a link to the project plan. So we can see here's the issues, here's the project plan, and since I have unit tests, I also created a GitHub action that anytime I commit a change to GitHub, this GitHub action will run, build the solution, and run all the unit tests and let me know if there is an error. I think this is an extremely important point. When you're sharing your code, you want to make sure it is stable, reliable, no bugs ideally, or very few bugs. So treat this as a professional project. Now to actually build the NuGet package from the project, if you right-click on your class library project, the one you're going to make into a package, and go to the properties, this is in Visual Studio 2022 Community Edition. If you click on the package over here, this is all the information about creating the NuGet package. The first thing you want to do is check the Generate NuGet Package on Build. So this way, instead of just creating DLLs, you create the NuPKG file. You need to give the package an ID, a name, and there are some rules here. You can't have spaces, characters that are not valid for URL, and it needs to be a unique name. If you're building the package just for your personal projects, you don't need to worry too much about having this a globally unique name, but you do need to have a unique name for each of your packages. For me, I prefixed it with my name, and that's so I can be sure this should be a very unique name when I publish this out to NuGet.org. If you're building something that you want to share with other developers at your company, you may prefix these with your division or your department or your team. If you're a developer on the accounting team, you may prefix all of your packages with accounting.whatever. If you're on the sales team, you may prefix it with sales.whatever. Just a way so that the other developers working at the company have an idea of what this package does. Next, you can give the author name and the company name, the product name, which in this case is just the assembly name. It helps to add a brief description here of what the NuGet package will do. Since I'm publishing this publicly, I have a copyright. I have a project URL that goes to a support page on my website. You can add the optional icon here, which I added just to make this look a little bit nicer. There's a link to the README file, which the README is part of the project, so this is a resource available in the build. If you have this on a repository, you can put in the URL for the repository and the repository type. You can add some tags to make this a little bit more searchable, and then you can optionally add some release notes. If you're releasing this publicly, you may want to add a license, so you can pick an embedded file, SPDX license expression, or none. For me, I did the SPDX license expression, and I selected MIT. So this will just display the MIT license when somebody gets the package from NuGet.org. And you have a checkbox here to require license acceptance. This could be if you're doing more of a commercial product that you want to potentially sell, you may want to do this, or if your code is using some other packages that have restricted licenses, you may need to do this. Since this is an MIT license NuGet package, I just left this unchecked. Now that you have the package configuration set up, right-click on the project that you want to create a package for and select the Pack option. This will build your project, and the final step will be to create the package in your bin release folder. So here's the package name with the version .nupkg. If we go look at this out in my directory, here's the NuGet package. There is a directory underneath it, in this case netstandard 2.0. You don't need to worry about this when you copy your package somewhere. You just need this new package file. This is actually a zip file that contains everything. So we can go to this and change the type from new package to zip. And you can open this up and see here's the README file, the package, the library, the releases, all the information about it. I'm going to go and rename this back to the new package extension. So now you have your NuGet package created. If this is just something you're going to use for personal development, you can just right click and copy this and put it in a directory on your computer. For me, I have a utilities private NuGet directory and I can just put my personal packages in here. If you're doing this for your company, you might have a network share that you want to put your NuGet packages on, or they may actually build a package server, which I won't get into the installation of that, but that's like creating your own private version of NuGet.org with your private company's packages. So they can only be used by other developers at your company, not by just any programmer on the planet. Or you could take this new package file, and if you wanted to share it with everybody, you can upload it to NuGet.org. And that's what I did with this one. It's fairly simple to go to NuGet.org, create an account, and upload one of your packages. Here's the README information, and that's the README file that I created, the README.md file. It shows the framework that it's in and that it can be used in. It shows any dependencies the DLL has. Here's the link to my project website, the source code repository, the MIT license. All of those values came from this configuration that I did here. Now, to use this package in a project, we would right-click on our solution or our project and say manage the NuGet packages for solution or project. And normally you'll see the package source of NuGet.org. And if you go to browse, you see a list of the common NuGet packages and you can search for a particular package. If you did not upload the package to NuGet and you just put this out on your local directory or on a network share, you would click this gear icon next to package source. And now you can manage your package sources. Normally you'll see NuGet.org and you'll probably see Microsoft Visual Studio Offline packages, which is just a local cache of some of the packages you've pulled down for your other projects. But you can click this green plus sign and add in a new package source. I already added one that I called private, and the source is my eUtilities private NuGet. This folder I showed earlier where I keep my private NuGet packages. You'd click OK to add that. And now you can change your package source from NuGet.org to your offline packages, your private, or you can do all, which will check in your offline packages, NuGet.org, and your private directory. So now if I search for Scott Lilly dot, since I named the package scottlilly.fluentemail, I see the package here and I can select it and add it to my projects. If I make updates to the package in the future, I want to be following good version numbering practices. Notice in the package name, it has the version number. So I don't want to just change the code and redeploy version 1.0.0. I would probably deploy version 1.1 or 1.0.1. And then if I made a significant change, I may do a version 2.0.0. By incrementing the version number of the package every time I make a change, that gives developers the opportunity to pick which version to use. Here I only have version 1, but if I release more changes to this package, then I could have version 1.1, 1.2, 2.0, and older projects using the older versions of the package would still be able to use that old version of the package, the 1.0 package. And this way I don't have to worry as much about making a breaking change, because someone using the package has to specifically pick which version they're using. And if I do make a change that breaks something, that changes the interface, the functionality, they can always use the older version of the package. So it doesn't take much to create a NuGet package. It's fairly simple. You do want to treat it like professional code because you are sharing the code across projects, maybe across developers, outside your company. But it lets us create more stable code faster in the future because we can just reuse our code this way. If you have any questions about creating NuGet packages for your personal projects, your company projects, or even to publish on NuGet.org, please leave a comment and I will try to respond to you as quickly as possible.